A moment in life comes when you realize that all these accumulations have still left you unaccomplished. There is a strange hollowness within which does not gratify to any extent. One probes one's own self, was this all to be accomplished in this life? Have I truly succeeded to achieve what all was expected from this human life? And then that inner probe leaves most of the people like you for a seeking, for a yearning, for a search, for search of that ultimate answer that was once researched and well established by our great masters during those unknown times. Like you, something similar happened with the Nachiketa. At the doors of the death, right sitting before Yamacharya, that relentless, young, tender-aged boy does not yield to any kind of allurement that is passed on to him as a bargain to settle and drop his seeking for an ultimate answer. What happens after death? What is this life? What is the journey of the soul? What is this all about? Where does this all lead towards? Yamacharya makes all effort to ensure that his bargain is able to deflect that boy towards seeking of transient pleasures. But Nachiketa probably had traveled a lot in his past lives, and the understanding that he had brought to that very life had confirmed him within that I am not going to settle for anything other than the self, the true self, the ultimate reality. All seeking apart from the true self is non-self, and all non-self is transient in nature. It's not going to stay. However may be the intensity of a pleasure, however unsurmountable its allurement may appear to be, but I am not going to settle for it. As a tough negotiator, without any resolve, he forced Yamacharya to reveal before him his true seeking. Teaching Upanishads in special reference to Kathopanishad. Taking the light of knowledge from the dialogue that transpired between Nachiketa and Yamacharya, equally bestows a blessedness within the student, within the seeker. You realize with your own first-hand experience about the discernment between self, non-self. Once you are able to discern between the self from the non-self, a great change comes within your own awareness. Your response to each and every situation outside, subject outside, people outside, and each and every desire within, perception within, imagination and holdings within, undergoes a great change. The moment you are able to discriminate between anatma and atma, non-self from self. You realize the kind of importance, entanglement, obsession, priority, importance, these are the words that approximate to the understanding. You must be able to afford to atma in comparison to anatma, self in comparison to non-self. The life outside may not change, but the experience within you, you, in you, undergoes a deep change. You start a fresh lease of life with the same set of things surrounding you. Something within undergoes a change. Just to draw an example, the vehicle remains the same, the driver has undergone a change. A driver with different set of discipline, perception, inner inklings, and that alters the way of driving. Inner equanimity, equipoise is given priority above any other thing. You keep striving for your worldly objectives. You do not settle. You do not compromise. But yet, there is an inner demarcation, discernment, where you do not give yourself as an oblation for the compromise in return for any allurement. And that is a major change in human life. Come, come, come and join me in the online classes that I conduct to teach Kathopanishad. Experience that learning by yourself. Attend those four classes being given to you as complimentary. Since I cannot judge about your capacity to understand, therefore I afford you an opportunity to take the first four classes without paying any fee to the teacher. And judge within yourself, examine yourself, whether this knowledge can render any benefit to your life. And if so, then continue for the remaining 32 classes to come. Come. Join the learning of Kathopanishads. Thank you.